Hey, welcome back to Aqua Sanctuary. I am Izzy Noodles. What is my name? It's Izzy Noodles. And I last left off having collected 2 out of 4 Aqua Gems. So if I turn around, you'll have an idea of whereabouts I am. And I am right now going to head into this cave. Can't get my words out today. So you want your pistols because there are some bats. You're with the bats. Oh, don't get me, please. Did one of them get me? I don't think it did. Bats can be brutal. Especially in the level editors. Wow is one word I would use for the bats. But anyway, we have got this really random trap here. I love it, and I'm going to show you what it does. Actually, I'm not going to save there. I'll save here. This is actually the first lever you want to pull. It's got a longer timer. So, just for the sake of showing you what happens when you mess up, I'm just gonna show you. It's quite shocking. So it's timed, and if you don't get the timers, let's just have a look. What will happen? That will happen. Shocking. Okay, so pretty damn short timers as well, and it's pretty difficult, so you want the one on the right hand side first. Fastest way is to simply turn and run naturally and then do this one. No sprinting or flipping. Turn and do a half tile jump, and you want to flip in the air, jump and grab. Awesome. So this is all down to, I was going to say luck, but just do your best. It is difficult. This is the method I have used is the, oh my goodness, I thought I did pretty good. Wow. Go, Lara, go. Come on. So close. Yash. Yash. There we go. So I was actually pretty shocked that I didn't make that the first time, but that's okay. So you want to hop down onto that ledge. Didn't really think to say that, but you can drop and grab a ledge below. Shimmy along to this gap. Okay, and now you can run along here, and it looks as though you have to jump the gaps over the spikes, but no, you will take damage, and you can just jump over here. Also, some flares in this little tiny gap. And if you continue this way, you've got a little cavey area, but we don't need that just yet. That is for later. So we'll come back to that later. So actually, because I've made it across that trap, I'm going to save. Okay. And just run and jump to here, and then you can make it to here. Awesome. So from here, you've got this chain you can pull. And pulling this chain does nothing except show you the solution to the puzzle. If you know the solution, you don't need to pull the chain. So you might want to just maybe draw that little doodle of that, because the redder tiles are the ones you want to stand on, and then that door will open, and you can just see there that there is a speck of blue. There is another aqua gem behind that door. And this is actually just directly below where we are now. This is right below. So to get out of this angle, either press the look button or hop backwards. And before I deal with that puzzle, I'm just going to go up there because there's just a couple of items up there. So if you don't want the items, you don't need to actually bother going up there. So do an intricate jump to there. You want to be all the way to the corner of that lower block, and then all the way to the corner of this one to be able to jump up. Okay, so just run around. So up here we have some shotgun shells. And across the far side we've got some Uzi clips. And also from here we can get another secret. Pretty long-winded secret, but never mind, we're here for the secrets. So from here just drop down and you can drop onto here. You can also jump to here from that lower section where we just were. Run to here. And through this first window, there's three windows through this first one, you can just grab these flares. These flares are not part of the secret. So just so you know that they are there and you can pick them up. So these jumps can be tricky. It's only the first time I tried to do this that I messed up, so it's not that bad. I do prefer to save though, so I don't keep having to do them, and I said they're not that bad and I fell. There we go. Awesome, so from here you can grab this ledge and shimmy. Okay. So hop into this center window. And you can jump into that gap right there. I recommend grabbing so you just slide all straight on in. And then you want to run and jump to that pillar in front. You might need to veer to the right a little bit because it's, whoops, a little off center. So she veered off because she actually banged her head. You know, I'm making such clumsy mistakes. Well, I veered a little too much to the right. That's fine, it's fine. Okay, and then you want to come over to here, but you do not want to grab. She will not make that jump if you grab. She just won't grab it. Don't know why. It is a thing where she won't grab. But anyway, from here, run and jump to the next window, and you do not want to just drop down because there is no ledge here. No ledge. So instead, you want to jump and grab this bit right here. Come all the way you can to one side, and then you can stand in the gap. And then hop to here, drop down. And here we are. Here's the secret that we did all that jumping around for. But I think the secrets are well worth it in this game. You do get quite a lot in the secrets. So from here you can run and jump to the corner there. Might want to save. Not a recommendation, I'm just saving. Okay, so an easy way back from here is because there is a crack on the opposite side of this column. You can just grab right here. Awesome stuff. Okay, so climb up and then just jump to the window. And then just shimmy back along and then you can just hop back the way you came. Simple as. Okay, so once you are back here, you could just drop down all the way to the ground where you were, but I'm gonna jump up here again. And the reason is, just want to be central. There is a jump switch right there. So that's the reason I did all them jumps all the way back. Just drop down, grab the jump switch, and it raises this, and now you have a much easier way back up. So, speaking of an easier way back up, I am actually going to go back up. So I only hopped down, so we've got this. Didn't have to activate it, but I did just for ease. We are going to have to come back here anyway. So I do recommend using that jump switch. Also, the jumps across to here and then the next jump, they are quite far apart, so you sometimes might need to line yourself up. So where I'm going now is I'm going to get the crowbar. I mentioned we need it earlier on because well, there's that particular secret that we need it for. And we need it for the what do we need it for? My mind's gone blank. But we need the crowbar to get the crossbow in order to solve the puzzle to get the last aqua gem. It's kind of an item to get an item. Oh no! Ooh, that's fine, I did a side flip. Didn't want to just jump forward. I'm just gonna jump over to here to get a small med pack. Ooh. If you're gonna fall, slide backwards. Okay, here's a med pack. Don't need it. But showing you it's there. So just hop back. And then from here, here is the crowbar. So just hop down. And we got the crowbar. So before I hop down any further, we have a secret we can get right here in this space. I was going to say crawl space, but I just went with space. Seriously, I'm rambling today. So the archway there may think that you're going to bang your head, but nope, Lara will just jump straight through that. So just do a standing jump, grab, and you will need to press the crawl button to get into this gap. And you get two lots of Uzi clips. Awesome. And when you drop down, you will not take any damage. So something I didn't mention is that we also need to do a torch puzzle. We will need to do that before we get our crossbow. You may have seen a few torches on the walls. We need to light those. There's five to light. So it can be a long-winded game, but it's still a very awesome game. So now I've got the crowbar, I'm going to use it, obviously. So firstly, this crowbar lever here. There we go, that's deactivated that trap right there. Gonna grab the key. Whoop. Whoops. And I took a bit of damage. Oh, I did not do that puzzle with the gem. I always forget to do that. Remind me to do that later, please. So from here, you want to just run and jump. There is a. Oh, for God's sake, I might just reload because I'm just taking loads of damage. Where did I last save? Alright, so I just picked up that secret, and while I'm in the area, I'm gonna go and do this because I forgot to do it the first time round. I should have done it once I used that jump switch. But I'm a silly goose and I forgot. So, don't forget, this is actually the starting tile, so you want to climb up here. And I often do a half tile jump, so you want to jump over to here. I reckon you could make that on just a regular jump, but I always just half tile, just cuz. Then this tile, and then this one. And you may think her foot is slightly touching another tile. It's actually quite forgiving. It's never not let me open the door yet. So there we go. So I also mentioned we've got a torch puzzle to do. And one time I forgot to pick this up. It seems to be a thing that I forget to pick up this gem. But one time I forgot and I did the torch puzzle. And that pedestal was actually on fire, but you can still pick up the gem. So that's actually the torch bug, or the fire bug, that you get in some games with the torch. Which is why they give you a pit of water to put the torch out in. So you just get random fire, but you can pick it up, you won't get set on fire, so don't panic. So now I've got that. Going to once again use the crowbar lever. Okay. And I'm gonna try a little bit better to pick up the damn keys. So I don't usually have so much trouble with jumping to here because there is this slope and I usually just jump off the slope. But I think I was just too far to one side, maybe. Just gonna save actually. Just to save me doing stuff all over again. There we go, that's how I try and do it. Don't usually need to line myself up though. So here's the gate key. And actually, if you run over to here, you've got a sneaky gap over here. And you can grab a med pack. Okay, so now I will use the key. And this just takes us to the torch. Okay, so if you approach the pedestal, you get a little scene that shows you where all the torches are. There are five altogether. So lighting all five gives access to the crossbow, which we can then use on the last gem puzzle. So before I pick up a torch, I'm just going to try and get around there. Just gonna use this not this pedestal. What is this? It's a lever. Gonna use the lever. Okay, so the lever opened the door right here. Grab a torch and we can go through the door. So, just gonna show you that. Oh my goodness. Okay. So, lever right here. This is timed and it turns on the fire. So it shows you where the fire is, but we don't need to know where the fire is. I already know. So, because it's timed, I'm gonna leave the torch where we're going to need it, which is right here. So you want the torch in front of where the fire was born. Oh, she's not turning very well. So, yeah, deep water and timers, not a good mix. But also, opposite the lever, you've got some more shotgun shells. So annoying. So, because she's wading, I'm just gonna jump up so she will stop wading. Gonna save, because it's a timer. And here we go, gonna pull the lever. Just done a roll, okay. Oh. So, do your best. You just want to be on this side and sort of run over the corners of the tiles. Wasn't perfect, but near enough. So, pick up your torch. Light your torch. There we go. Just enough time. So the first torch I am going to light on the wall is over here. And don't forget to put your torch down without throwing it. You want to select your pistols. There we go. So we want to get the torch on top of this column. I know. So we want to actually lower the column, put the torch on it, raise the column. So we've already done this before, so I will just speed up the video because you know exactly what I'm doing. Just dealing with the column. Okay, so now just run back and put your torch on that block. Right, so just equip your pistols and she'll drop the torch. And now the block is down, we have to do this the long-winded way to get that block back up. So you want to stand on here. So, making your way back up, just as you have before. Alright, that's that done again, and so let's just do the next bit again. Alright. So just climb up and grab your torch. And when you've got a lit torch, I don't know about you, but I have a habit of saving a lot more often. Okay, so you may or may not have spotted where to put that, or where to light the wall torch rather. So when you jump to here, you want to go from the right-hand side closer to the wall because, yeah, that's why. That is why. There is a part where you will bang your head. I messed up. So hug the wall. There you go. And I didn't mention before, but you want to do a half tile jump from here. Not certain why I didn't bother to say it. I don't think I said it. I don't know. That was a while ago. But now we actually want to run and jump to here. And you can just throw your torch. Well, maybe not. But you want to throw your torch straight into that gap. Awesome. So, just jump back to that column. Wow, Lara. Why? And this bit can be slightly tricky to get back to, just because you've got that bit by Lara's foot. It's not a straight, flat, you know, words. Words fail me. But sometimes she messes up her running jump because it's not a flat surface. There we go, that was good. That was fine. So just run and jump here and then just grab the next ledge. And then you can just run and jump over to here. Awesome, so just grab your torch. Like this one. So that's shown as a door, nothing has happened. Surely a clue that you need to do more to get the door open. So that's actually where the crossbow is. Also, from here, I have not yet found a way to not take damage, so you just have to sort of make do. There you go. Gonna take a little bit of damage on that fall. So, next torch. Please, Lara, hurry up. I'm going to go into the cave where the spikes were. Okay, so that's what this funny looking bit here is for. So, oh, you do want to be on this slightly higher bit, for goodness sake. Having a bad time with buttons today. Please. So you do want to come right forward if you can, and then just standing jump to this lower point, Sjurpa-Djurpa. Just throw the torch in, there we go, and then just go up to the top. Now you can do that timer again, but I am actually just going to do the easy way of coming over here and climbing up the column that we raised. It is just easier. Okay, so then you can just run and jump to here and again to here. Now you can go into that little random cave area because this is exactly what it is for. It's for the torch. Yes. So you're better off being to the right just because it's slightly lower here and slightly higher just where I was standing. And then come to the opposite side just for the same reasons. And then just standing jump into here. Smashing. So run and jump to here, and again here. And here is another torch. And to light this one, you actually want to be just on this higher block. Could you be on the higher block, please? Thank you. Please and thank you. So it can take some lining up. For some reason. There you go. Awesome. So it really doesn't matter what order you light the torches in. So you can just throw that down. There you go, and then you can grab this to have a safer way down. No thank you. Okay, next torch I'm going for is over here, which I didn't point out. So you've got those levers there, I will show you that in just a moment. So the torch we want to light is all the way at the other end, and we need to raise blocks out of the water so that we can get the torch across. So I do often save right before throwing the torch down, just in case. So select your pistols, she'll drop it down, and now we're going to go back outside to those levers. So pull the first one. So that raises a block, and it stops you pulling these other two levers. So you can only have one block up at a time. It's pretty simple, it's just long-winded. So, grab this, and then just hop along, and again, and then put your torch down again, and hop back. Back to the levers. So pull the lever to lower that block, and it will allow you to raise another block. So that's all you're doing. It's long-winded, but it is simple. Okay, so for this last one, you don't want to be too far forward, otherwise Lara will actually bang her head. So just in case I'm in the wrong place. So I've said before, there will be a lot of saving in this game. That was perfect. Okay. So to get your torch back across, it's exactly the same deal as before. But first, just gonna drop the torch down and then hop in the water for a secret. So just through this little space, there is... Wow, there we go. There is a secret. A very small secret, actually. But that's fine. We've had the same equivalent earlier on. But at least it's two lots of, and it's Uzi shells. Or Uzi bullets, rather. Uzi clips. Whatever you want to call them. So like I said, actually I don't think I said it, but to get the torch back is exactly the same as what you've just done. Awesome! So you've got your torch back. Finally! So, next torch is down in this lower section. And I didn't bother to point it out because that's all that's there. So over here in this little corner is a little tiny cave. And all there is a wall torch. Simple. So simple. Simple as. Awesome. So, last torch is actually all the way back in the other area where we came from. Whoops, ran into a... Well, I was going to say wall, it's not actually a wall. Here we go. So in terms of some sort of landmark, that's the timed tile. Well, what did I call it? A platform, timed platform. And here is our torch, a wall torch. Awesome. So we don't need that anymore. And now I'm actually going to dive into the water with a badass spin. And because I'm coming into the water, because we have our secret that's right at the start of the level. Bet you'd forgotten all about that. Here it is. So now we've got the crowbar, we can open this door. And inside are the Wheezies. So you've got a load of ammo pickup as well, so make sure you pick everything up from this pedestal, because the Uzis are the last thing to pick up. Make sure you grab everything. So now you've got those, you actually have to make your way all the way back up to where we were. So I will meet you back at that spot. Awesome, here we are, and I am right now going to go and grab the crossbow, which is actually at the other end of the area. Whoops. Okay, so she won't jump back because it's kind of deep. Okay, so if you remember where the timer was for the flame to light the torch, that is where we're going to get the crossbow. Down here. Here we go. Awesome, so here is the crossbow. And you may have recalled that I said that the puzzle for the crossbow, where exactly it was, you may recall where I said it was. Yeah, that's all the way back where we were. So, yeah, thorough. Okay, here we are, finally at these coloured blocks. So these blocks, once you step on them, are for a different little door, and they are timed. So, just so you know, you have to find the door first though. So I'm going to combine the laser sight with the crossbow, equip it, and then save, because I don't want to just keep wasting arrows, even though I'm not actually going to be using the crossbow very much. It's just a weapon that I don't tend to use much in this particular game. So other games I might use it quite often, but this one I've not had any real use for it. So once you stand on the block, it will show you what door has opened. So it's when you step off the block that the timer starts. But it's not showing you exactly where that door is. So it can take some time, but jump off the block and try not to press every single wrong button. So I'm going to try that again. Okay. There we go, there's the sprint button. My goodness. So your first one is behind the tree. Don't know if I'll hit it. Yes! I didn't know if the tree would be in the way. But you do have quite a wide hitbox for hitting the targets. Saving again just because of ammo situation. Really don't need to, but whatever, it's just a tactic. So So this green one is actually the worst one so far away. So all the way back where we got the crossbow. Yeah, so you don't have to be precise when you are shooting the targets. Okay, so down the step, don't forget to stop sprinting if you're turning a corner, just because it's much easier. Wow, not gonna make it. Yeah. So I'll just reload. Okay, so don't forget to actually take your crossbow out before trying to look at the target. So I got it that time. Good. So now just make your way back to the boxes. Okay, so last one. This one is pretty darn easy. There it is, right up there. And that has opened the gate right here to our last aqua gem. Awesome. So now we have 4 gems and we can go and place them. Let me just check I have all 4, because I've made mistakes in the past. There we go, all 4 of them. Yeah, I've done the puzzles and just forgotten to pick the gems up. But I've got them. Don't panic. Okay, so just hop on up to the obelisk. Here we go, and I am actually not going to place them this time. I will place them next time. So, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Take it easy, guys.